The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 14th of December, 1972, in Ahmedabad, India.
Yogam Jinjan Madasraya Asangsayam Samagra Mam Dasabhasasi Dachshu. So Krishna is advising simply by increasing your attachment for Krishna, simply always being absorbed in the thought of Krishna, we can be eligible to understand the whole knowledge, complete knowledge, without any doubt. By our mental speculation, we acquire knowledge, but there are so many doubts. In the 9th chapter, also in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, pratyakham avagamam dharmam. Pratyakham, Krishna consciousness, knowledge, is so perfect that pratyakham avagamam. You can directly perceive how far you are making progress. You don't require to take certificate from others whether you are progressing or not. You will understand yourself. The example is given just like a hungry man is eating. So, as he is going on eating, he is getting strength and his hunger is being satisfied. So he can understand himself. Nobody requires to certify, now you are satisfied or now. Similarly, bhakti, Krishna consciousness, is so perfect that pratyakham avagamam, one can understand directly. Bhakti parishanubhava virakti annatrasya. This is the test of bhakti marga. Therefore Krishna says, asamsam. The theoretical knowledge, experimental knowledge, always remains in doubt. All the scientists, they are not confident. Now there is a theory of uncertainty among the scientists. Whatever knowledge they are making progress, everything is answered. Yes, it must be answered. Because the basic principle is wrong, therefore it must be answered. A conditioned soul, as we are, under the condition of the material nature, three modes of material nature, how our knowledge can be perfect? So it is not first. The first defect is, because we are conditioned, we commit mistakes, so many, and we become illusion. Just like every knowledge is being based on the illusion that I am this body, material body, which I am not. But the whole world is going on under this conception that I am this body. I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman, like that. So, the basic principle is illusion. And there are so many mistakes we commit. And the senses are imperfect. And although my senses are imperfect, I still theorize, it may be, it is like this, it is like that. These are all imperfect things. Therefore, whatever knowledge we may make progress, it is samsayam, it remains uncertain. But what Krishna says, you can test him with your experimental knowledge. That is Vedic knowledge. Vedic knowledge, it is not dogma. The statement is there after sufficient experiment. So if we accept Vedic knowledge, we save so much time. We may go on experimenting with our limited power of senses, But that will always remain doubtful. But if we accept Vedic knowledge, apurusha knowledge, then it is perfect. Asamsayam samagram. This samagram, this word is very significant. Samagram means complete. To understand Krishna means to understand the whole cosmic manifestation, God, the material nature, the time factor, the living entities, their respective relationship, everything that is called samagram. Not that a Krishna conscious person does not know about the creation of the material manifestation. He knows by his reason. That will be explained in this chapter, seventh chapter, how this material creation is going on. The modern scientists, they put up creation that there was a chunk and it was burst into pieces, then the planetary system came into existence. But if we inquire where from this chunk comes, that they cannot answer. Therefore, the so-called scientific knowledge always remains in doubt. Darwin's theory, there are so many passages, it may be, perhaps. So, these things perhaps, it may be, that is not certain. Therefore, they have now accepted the theory of uncertainty. But here, if we hear from Krishna, then it is perfect knowledge, samagram. How this material world is created, how these are five elements or gross elements come into existence, everything will be explained. Asamsayam samagrama. To understand Krishna means to understand everything. Therefore, tatyam manushyanam sahasyeshu kosti jatati siddhaye jatatamabhi siddhyanam kosti vrittimam tatha. We have to understand Krishna in truth. Simply, superficially, if we understand Krishna, that Krishna was born of the father and mother, Devaki and Vasudeva, and he was born in Mathura, and then played with the gopis, and then he taught something on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, that is not sufficient enough. We should try to understand samagra as far as possible, incomplete. Then our devotion, our love for Krishna will be increased. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is said, Siddhanta bholiya chitte nakaro olos. Yaha haite Krishna lage sudhira manas. Siddhanta, conclusion, understanding. You should try to understand Krishna. Simply by understanding Krishna, life becomes perfect. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattva. Tapta deham punar janma nahi. We can become liberated. Therefore, Kaviraj Goswami recommends that try to understand Krishna in truth. And another place, it is said, Chaitanyer dayar katha karoho vichar. Vichar karile chitte pave chamakta. It is not blindly accepted. This Krishna consciousness, with considerable deliberation, we take the decision. All the acharyas, they are taking decision. Therefore, in the next verse, Krishna says, jnanam piham sabhijnanam. This knowledge will practical understanding. Sabhijnanam. Vijnanam means practical application. We understand Krishna as the Supreme. He is the creator of this cosmic manifestation. He is the Supreme. We are all subordinate. This is jnanam and sabhijnanam. When it is practically applied, that means when you take to devotional service, then it is practically application, practice. Jnanam piham sabhijnanam bhakthami asesata jat gyatani abhuya annat jnatabvam avasishyate. So, when he understands perfectly, complete knowledge, then there is no more anything remains to be understood, everything. Tasmin vijñāte sarvam idam vijñātam bhavati. So, the Bhagavad Gita is not theory, it is knowledge and practically applicable in life, savijñā. And if we try to understand Krishna in perfect order, then there is nothing remains to be understood. Everything becomes revealed. This knowledge becomes revealed. Nāhaṁ prakāsa sarvasya yuga māyā samāg. Revealed. Athāpi te deva padāṁ mujadna prasāda līśāna grhītaya. So we have to receive this knowledge submissively. Lord Brahma recommends that yāne prayāsam mudupāsa namanta eva. Namanta eva. We must be submissive. The whole thing depends spiritual knowledge. Tad vijñānārtham sa guru meva virache samitpāni sotriyam brahmane. Tad viddhi pranipāte na pariprasne na sivaya. So, this knowledge, this process of knowledge is received by submissive mood, jnana prayasam, udapasana. One has to give up the false, prestigious position that I can understand God and everything by my speculative, experimental knowledge. This is called jnana prayasam. Jnana prayasam udapasana namanta eva. One should be submissive. Sarvakuritāna bhavadīya vārtāṁ. And try to hear the message of the Lord from sarvakuritāṁ, sādhu, devotees. Sarva, not professional. Sanātana Goswāmī has strictly forbidden avaiṣṇava mukhadgīna pūta hari kathāmṛtam saranam na kartavyam. Avaiṣṇava, those are not practically Vaiṣṇava, devotees in practical life. Professional person, there is no use. Avaiṣṇava, there must be heart and soul Vaiṣṇava. Avaiṣṇava mukhadgīnam pūto harikathāmṛta. Harikathā, the words about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, certainly that is amṛta. But still, it should not be heard from a person who is not a devotee. So, avaiṣṇava mukhadgīna pūta hari kathāmṛtam savanam na kartavyam. And it is forbidden, don't hear. Why? Hari kathāmṛta, Krishna kathā, the message of God, the words of God, Bhagavad Gita, he may be anything, but the kathā is the same, so what is the harm to hear from avaiṣṇava? Sanātana Goswāmī gives the example. Sarpachista payojatha. Sarpachista payojatha. Sarpachista, just like milk, everyone knows. A very nice food, most nutritious food. But if it is touched by the leaf of a serpent, it immediately spoils. Immediately. Another place, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Mayavadi bhasya sunile hoye sarvana. If we hear Mayavadi bhāṣya, commentaries by the Mayavadis, those who do not accept the personality of God, they are called Mayavadi. Mayavadi means they see everything Maya, even Krishna is Maya. That is called Mayavadi. The Mayavadi philosophy is that when Krishna comes, he comes with a material body. That is called Mayavadi. God is impersonal. When he comes, he takes a form. He takes the form of matter. This is Mayavadi. There are so many faulty statements of the Mayavadi. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said, Mayavadi hoy Krishna aporadi. They are offenders. Offenders. Therefore, Mayavadi bhasya sunile hoy sarvana. One becomes doomed by hearing the Mayavadi commentary. This is so much condemned. So, actually, by the grace of Krishna, we can understand that the Absolute Truth is ultimately the Supreme Person. But we cannot accommodate within our teeny brain, how the Supreme Absolute Truth can be a person. That is the difficulty. That is the difficulty of Mayavad philosophy. That is the Kupaman Lukarna. That because I am a person, I am so much limited. How a person can be unlimited? And that is the difficulty for them. But therefore, to remove this difficulty, one has to surrender. Without surrendering, it is not possible to understand. Therefore, Krishna demands, surrender. Then you will understand. Naham prakasa sarvasya yuga maya samabhati. By challenging, you cannot understand actually what is Krishna. One has to become submissive. So, jnanam teham sabhijnanam idam vakshami asesata. Just gyatya. Na iha bhuya annas gyatam bhamma vasishtate. Then Krishna says, manusyanam sahasresu kaschi jatati siddha. Jatatam api siddhanam kaschi maang vetti tato. Manusyanam sahasresu. Generally, all human society, especially at the present moment, nobody cares for perfection of life. They do not know what is perfection of life. Just like animals, they do not know what is perfection of life. They think perfection of life to gratify the senses. We have got the senses, let us, because they have no idea that there is life after death. Therefore, their only proposition is, now we have got this life, we have got these senses, let us enjoy it to the fullest extent. This is their perfection. But actually that is not perfection. Perfection means, self-realization means to know that aham brahmasmi, I am not this matter, I am spirit soul. To understand this. Brahma bhuta prasanna. So therefore, mostly people are engaged in the animal propensities of life. Ahara nidra bhayamaitanach. Eating, sleeping, sex life and defense. They are busy. But these things are visible in the animal life also. Then what is the special significance of the human life? Human life means athātva brahma jigyāsa. The human being should be inquisitive to understand Brahma. That is the special significance of human life. Narottam Das Thakur therefore says, manusya janama paiya radha krishna nabhujya janiya suniya visha phai. Narottam Das Thakur laments, hari hari vifale janama paiya. My Lord, I have simply spoiled my life. Why? You are spoiled, you are eating very nicely, sleeping very nicely. No! Manusya janama radha krishna, manusya janama. This human form of life is specially meant for understanding Radha Krishna. Krishna means Radha Krishna. Krishna means everything, samagra. So understand Krishna. That is the special mission of human life. So I did not try for it. I simply carried away by the waves of Maya. The Bhaktivinoda Thakur sings, Mayar vase jaccha bhese khaccha habu durubhai. We are being carried away by the waves of this material modes of nature, sometimes drowned, sometimes on the surface, in this way our life is going on. Jeev Krishna das evi shas kalle tvar dukhana. But we can stop this being carried away by the waves of Maya simply if we accept that we are eternal servant of Krishna. We can stop the carrying away. Therefore, people do not understand. Krishna himself says, manusyanam sahasresu. Sahasresu means out of millions of them. They are interested how to make life perfect. Nobody is interested, especially in this age. In this age, prayana alpa ayusa sambha kalavasmin jivijana. The first disqualification is that in this age, people do not live for a long time. What's this story? Formerly they were healthy and they could live about 100 years. As we have seen our grandfather. They used to live My grandmother died at the age of 96 years. Similarly, there are many instances. People used to live for a long time. But the first qualification of this age, they are dying 50, 60, 45. The India's average age is 35. In other countries, little more. So practically, nobody is living very long time. Prayanol Puyal and Munda, they do not know that they have a mission of life. Siddhi, Siddhila, they do not know. Like cats and dogs dying. Prayanol Puyal, Shatalo, Sindhiji, Munda, Sumanda Matayo. And if one is interested for spiritual life, they are also captured by so many pseudo-spiritual things. Pseudo, mandas, prayanalpayaiso, kalavasminjugi jana, mandas, sumandha matas. They have got a different views. They do not like to get perfect knowledge from the Vedic literature or from Bhagavad Gita. They manufacture their own way of life. This manda sumandha matayo and manda bhagya and unfortunate. Mostly they are unfortunate. And chupadrita and discharged by so many things, sometimes earthquake, sometimes famine, sometimes scarcity of water, sometimes war, sometimes fight, so many things. Problems, simply problems. This is the position of this age. So if one is actually interested to make his life perfect, then we should accept the standard knowledge instead of manufacturing different ways. No. Here is standard knowledge, Bhagavad Gita, the Shastra, Sadhu Shastra Guru Bhakta, Tinete Kuryaya, Jasastra Vidimus Sijya Vartape Kamakar. If you do not follow the standard knowledge of perfect Shastra, then Krishna says, na siddhi sabhamati, he never gets siddhi. Here it is said, siddhaye, manasthanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaye. Siddhaye, to become perfect. So, unless we follow the injunction of the Shastra, then there is no possibility of siddhi. Na siddhi sabhamati, na sukham na parangati. Neither perfection, neither happiness in this life, and what to speak of next life. These things are not possible if you do not follow standard knowledge. So, for this standard knowledge, manushanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaya. And those who have taken the standard knowledge, jatatama visiddhyana. So, by standard knowledge, by understanding Vedas, that is standard knowledge, still, although they are siddhas, still they do not understand Krishna. That's like kurmis, ganis, yogis, they are taken to standard knowledge. That's a fact. But still, they cannot understand Krishna. The mayavadi, the impersonalists, the speculators, they cannot understand. They are surprised. How Krishna can be this absolute truth? Even a great scholar, Dr. Radha Krishna, he is also amazed. He says that Bhagavad Gita is mental speculation. And when Krishna says on the 9th chapter, he writes commentary, Manmana Bhagavad Bhakta Madhyaji Namastu, he says that it is not up to Krishna, but the fact which is within Krishna. So he does not know what is Krishna, and he says, he dares to write commentary on Bhagavad Gita. This is the difficulty. Krishna has no inside or outside. Krishna is all spirit, Sachidananda Vigraha. So, he does not know. Not only he, many does not know. But the thing is that they dare to write commentary on Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, here it is said, the manushanam sahasres, kaschi jatati siddhan, jatatavapi siddhan. First of all, one must be perfect. And amongst the perfect, Krishna is known very rarely. Amongst the perfect, what you speak of the imperfect? Manushanam sahasya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, therefore, koti karmi madhye ag ganishas. There are millions and millions of karmis working hard for sense gratification. They are called karmis. Koti karmi madhye ag ganishas. One becomes gani, he is chief. Then koti gani madhye ag muktasas. Out of many thousands of gani, one becomes actually liberated. And koti mukta madhye dullha krishna. He says, out of many muktas, liberated souls, it is very difficult to find out a Krishna bhakta, a devotee of Krishna. These things are there. The Krishna also says, manasanam sahasre sukhasthi dhatati siddhaya. But this Krishna bhakti has become easily available through the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so liberal that Rupa Goswami offered him respect. Namo Mahavadanaya, Krishna Prema Pradaya. People cannot understand what is Krishna and what to speak of Krishna Prema, love of Krishna. It is far, far away. But you are so magnanimous that you are distributing this Krishna Prema to everyone. Namo Mahavadanaya, Krishna Prema Pradayati, Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanyana. You are Krishna, I can understand, but you have now appeared in the name of Krishna Chaitanya. Namo Mahavadanaya, Krishna Prema Pradayati, Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurattisi Namonu. So, Lord Chaitanya is accepted as Krishna himself, Krishna Vannam Tishatra. There are many evidences in the Shastra. So, it is due to Lord Chaitanya's mercy, if we go through the methods, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared as a devotee to teach us how to execute devotional service. So if we follow the footprints of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then Krishna Bhakti becomes very easily available. Therefore, first of all, we offer our respect to Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar, Sivasadi, Gaur Bhaktavit. Then we chant Hare Krishna, because by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, it will be easier to approach Krishna. Tadbiddhi Panipatena, as it is stated. So, manushanam sahasresu kasti jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhyanam kasti maam deti tattata. So, Krishna consciousness, although it is very difficult, by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, it has become easily available. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has recommended Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtana. He has recommended Sri Krishna Sankirtana, although he is Krishna himself, his word is sufficient. Still, whatever he said, he gave reference to the Shastra. Otherwise, it is not the authority. That is recommended in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Kirtana Deva Krishna Sa Mukta Sangha Parangrave. These are the recommendations. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whatever he has given us, not whimsically, according to the regulation of the Shastra. And if we follow the footprints of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then Krishna consciousness will be very easily understandable. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has recommended, Jare dakho tare kaha Krishna upadesh. This is the Krishna consciousness movement that according to the order of Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are trying to distribute the words given by Krishna, Krishna Katha. Krishna Katha means the words given by Krishna and the words about Krishna. The words given by Krishna personally is this Bhagavad Gita, and words about Krishna is Srimad Bhagavatam. So, this Krishna consciousness movement means preaching these two principal Vedic literature throughout the whole world. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. That every living entity is Prakriti. Every living entity. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Aparayam itasu vidhime prakritim para.
Jiva Bhut.
Every living entity is over. Those who are thinking of becoming man, they are in illusion. Prakriti Purush. Purush means the Bhokta, the enjoyer. And Prakriti, Kri means enjoyer. So every living entity is described as Prakriti. No living entity is Purusha. Purusha is only Krishna. So when we are thinking I become a Purusha, enjoyer, that is Maya. That is Maya. Actually, every one of us, woman, Prakriti. Every one of us. And every one of us is thinking as man. Even the woman. Man means enjoy. So everyone is thinking, I am enjoying. So this is called Maya. And about the gopis, it is better not to speculate. The speculator's writing has no value. Gopis, they are pleasure potency expansion of Krishna. Ananda chinmaya sadu jalavigrahas. Ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavitabhi. Stabhija eva nijagrupataya kalabhi. Goloka eva nimasati akhilatma bhuta govindamani purusha. So gopis are also expansion of Krishna. Krishna's pleasure potency. Gopis are not this ordinary woman. Neither Krishna is ordinary man. So, unless we understand Krishna, as we are discussing this morning, the verse, kaschit vyaktimam tattva, out of many millions of siddhas, one can understand Krishna as he is. If we do not understand Krishna, then how we can understand gopis? So this is not the subject matter of the mental speculators. Better not to read all these books. Because they are not realized souls, neither they are devotees of Krishna, neither they know what is Krishna. So why they will understand about Krishna? So if we want to understand gopis, then we have to learn it from the perfect devotee of Krishna, not from the speculators. Mental speculators. This is simply a waste of time. That time Narottama Thakur said, Rupa Raghu Natho Pade Haive Akuti Kabehama Bujhava Se Jugala Piriti. Jugala Piriti. The love between Krishna and Radharani. The gopis are expansion of Radharani. Pleasure potency of Krishna. These are all spiritual subject matter. So this is not mental. An ordinary man, if he thinks that I am becoming, that is artificial. That is artificial. This is not artificial thing. And the parokya ras, the sense of paramahansa, that is also there. But this is not this parokya ras, as we understand from this material world. Therefore, Sanatana Goswami has said that Avaishnava Mukhat Girna Puta Hari Kathamrita Samaram Nakatam. One who is not Vaishnava. So it is mental speculator. It is useless to learn from them what is the relationship between the gopis and Krishna. Neither it has to be practiced artificially. These things are rejected. So my request is that you should not read all these books. Simply waste your time. Krishna, Krishna's pleasure potency. This has been discussed by Srila Jiva Goswami, that Krishna is Parabrahma, and to relish Brahma Sukha, a person in austerity gives up all the material sense enjoyment. Tapasa Brahmacharyena, they try to relish Brahma Sukha. Now, when the Brahma Sukha Anubhuti, Krishna is the goal of Brahma Sukha Anubhuti. So, when Brahma wants to have pleasure, does it mean that he takes pleasure within this material world? To understand Brahma, one has to give up all material pleasures. And when the Brahma releases pleasure, does it mean this is material pleasure? Try to understand this fact. For releasing Brahma Sukha, one undergoes severe austerities. Tapasa brahmacharyena samena dhamena. There are so many processes. Tapo vidvam suddhita satya. For purifying our existence, we have to adopt so many means of austerities for understanding what is Brahma Sukha. Now, the reservoir of Brahma Sukha, Krishna, Parabrahma, when he enjoys, does it mean this is material thing? This is not material thing. Ananda Chinmaya Rasa Pratibhavi, that is the expansion of his spiritual bliss. Radha Krishna Pranaya Brikiti Allahadini Shakti Asma. That is the expansion of Krishna's Allahadini Shakti. So, first of all, we have to understand Krishna. Then, in course of understanding Krishna, we shall understand His Sammit Shakti, Allahadini Shakti. So, these things are not subject matter for studying in our conditioned life. It is for the liberated soul. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will find in the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he only once discussed about the love affairs of Krishna with Radharani, Gopi, with Ramananda Rao. Never he discussed with anyone else, because he was very elevated, Ramananda Rao. And otherwise, he never discussed. In the Bhagavad Gita also, you won't find Krishna is teaching anything about his relationship with gopis. So that's right to understand. This is not the subject matter for a person who is conditioned. Neither it is a subject matter to be discussed and speculated by the conditioned soul. Try to understand. This is practice. Abhyasa yoga yuktena sikasa nanagata. When you go to the puja room, we take our flowers and chandan offered to the lotus feet of Krishna. So gradually our mind will be concentrated. Just like not nowadays, formerly very young girls were married. My eldest sister was married at the age of 9 years. So I heard that my mother-in-law was married at the age of 7 years. I was Grihastha, and I was also married. My wife was 11 years. So, in that minor ages, there is no actually love between husband and wife. But still, formally, the system was that the young girl, minor girl, was giving some eatable foodstuff to the husband, and sometimes pan, like that. But unless they are major, they are not allowed to live together. But these things are going on. So, similarly, gradually, we develop our love for Krishna. As the same example, in the young age, the minor girl and the young boy, they do not come to the love platform. But in mature time, they become so lovable each other that they cannot be separate. Similarly, we have to practice. This Archan Marga means practice. Immediately, you cannot expect that your mind is completely fixed up with Krishna. But if we follow the regulative principles, then it will mature. Mature. And mature state, there will be love. So don't be disappointed. Go on with your regulative principles as that advice in the Shastra and the Guru, Sadhu Guru Shastra Bhakta. We have to stick to the principle. Therefore Rupa Goswami says, Utsahat, Bhajyat, Nishchayat, Tattat Parma Pravartana, Sato vitte sadhu sange sarvi bhakti prasiddh. The first thing is usaha. Usaha. Simply on the words of Krishna, that Krishna said, sarvadhanman parityajyamametam saranam. We must be very enthusiastic. But I must surrender to Krishna. Although my mind is going outside, but I must be determined that I must surrender. Usaha. This is called usaha. Enthusiasm. Dhaijya. Dhaijya means patience. Oh, I wanted to surrender to Krishna, but mind is going somewhere else. This disturbance. Therefore, this dhaijya. You must be patient. Usaha, dhaijya, nishcha. Nishcha means must be confident. Krishna has said that you surrender unto me and he will give me protection. He must be in me. So I must surrender. This is called nishchaya. Usaha, dhajyat, nishchaya, tattat karma pravartanat. And you must execute your business as it is advised by this Shastra and Guru. So usaha, dhajyat, nishchaya, tattat karma pravartanat, sato vritti. Your dealings must be very honest, not duplicity. Tattat karma pravartanat. Sato vitte sadhu sanga. Therefore this association is required. Sadhu sanga is very powerful. Therefore we have opened this society. Society means if you come to the society and if the society is nice, then automatically you love, you become attached. Just like if we mix, intermingle with drunkard society, gradually become drunkard. Similarly, if we intermingle with the sadhus, with the devotees, then automatically we become devotees. Sangat sanjayate kama. Therefore, sadhu sangha is very important. Satantra sangato bija sangvida bhavanti ritkanna rasayana katha. Tajosanat asu apavarga vartmani sadhya bhakti rati ranukramish. These are the sattric injunctions. So, as far as possible, we should adu sadhya tatu sadhusanga. Sadhusanga is very important. Nowadays it is very difficult to find out sadhusanga. Therefore, we are trying to spread this society's movement so people may take advantage of sadhu sangha, and that automatically, very easily, things may be successful.